This will be the spindle. This will be the board. And this stick will be the bow. I made this fork-like end for attaching some bark for the string. Don't know if it will work. But now I need to carve the spindle out of this one. And as you can see, the wood is quite crisp. It cracks off when I cut it out, but usually it's only the outer part that behaves like this. But it can also be a good sign that the wood has the right consistency for an easy boatwell fire, which is necessary if I want to try out using bark. See, when I reach the middle of the wood, it is less crisp, so I can actually make feathers that hang together. Okay, I will finish the spindle up. So this is my spindle, it's complete. It's a bit thick, as I said, this blade is a quarter inch wide at the base. So you have an idea, it's about 8 inches long in total, the knife. I like big spindles because I usually drill off quite a bit of the length, so I have some length to work on, and I like to start out with a wide spindle because I can always trim it down, but I can't do the opposite. So this is my kind of spindle with this down gearing section where I transition down to a smaller diameter. This way the string will be less stressed and it will have a larger surface area to grip. If I use a long bow, I compensate for the lack of speed in this area. And I can use a lot more downward force when I'm spinning it, because the string won't slip. So this works for me, and I think it's the best way to use this gearing kind of thing. I have no idea what to call it, so I call it a down gearing. I need to find some bark that's suitable for the boatwheel string. And this is elm. It's easy to strip off. I also had a piece lying over there. This is a tree that was fallen in. In a storm. Maybe a half a year ago. But the bark is still strong and it's easy to strip off this branch. Fast growing branches that are young usually have the best bark. elm bark is far stronger and far more flexible than willow bark. There's a quite large willow thicket just this way, 50 meters. But I would always choose elm bark over willow bark. It's much better. These pieces, they are quite long, maybe 3 meters, and the only reason they aren't longer is because this is how long the branch was that I was stripping it from. So elm bark is extremely easy to strip, and it's strong and it's flexible. So with this bark, I folded it over. I'm just twisting it. I tried this before, but the bark wasn't good enough for this. Elm bark is the best I have tried. Basswood should be better. Put it in the fork, twist it around, and then down over here. Quite simple, but it's strong. Ah, it was on the wrong side. So this is my bow. I don't know if I will see if this is adequate, otherwise I'll just hold it wrap it around my hand and hold it in my hand. I have done before. I do have a tinder bundle ready. This is poplar leaves. If you can see the consistency of this one, it's maybe the best tinder bundle material I have met. It's excellent because it's fluffy, and it's only the skeleton of the leaves that are left after decomposition. Then I actually found some dry punk wood. That's rare because it absorbs water like a sponge. You can see it's from this. from this block of wood, and the part that was exposed to the sun is actually dry, and the other side is wet. But this is excellent, because when these start burning, they burn quite a long, so they ensure that your coal will be extended as like a coal extender or something. They easily start burning like a cigarette, smoldering like a cigarette. This is a complete set. My spindle and pretty real noticed I have made a trench for the bow to run in, so I don't hit the ground or hit any objects with the point of the bow when I am bowing. This is the poplar hand socket. It's actually pointy enough so the end of the spindle is pointy enough so I can just stick it in without having the need for cutting this notch. And this will be my base for the coal when I have done the burning in and may make the cutout. So I will start with the... And this was the bow. This is the interesting part. I know this will work, the set, but I don't know if the cord is good enough. It's always interesting. For some stupid reason, I must not have turned on the camera, but I started the new string, and just as focus. And just as it slipped down on the spindle, I actually had a coal. It was way easy. It sucks that you didn't see me make this coal, but it was. So. For what reason it was, I didn't catch me making the coal, so I'll try to do it again. So the new string, I tried to be more consistent with the way I twisted the bark. I've used. I mean, it's clove hitches, the English name of the old bowl strings to tie this one on. I only have just tied in knots in this string, and around the string I have used clove hitches, with the old broken strings to tie this one on, because 1 meter wasn't long enough. Okay, let's try it out. I need to get it out of the notch, otherwise I don't get enough oxygen. I've just let it sit for a while, so the coal will grow larger in the remaining unburned dust. And it's quite windy today, so you can see it. I don't need to give it any air. So this string worked. I would say these strings are about for 1.5 coal. Don't know if you can see it, but it's actually start to polish out in the bottom of this circuit, because it reaches the dry bark that you also can see here, and it's super nice for a hand tool circuit. I will keep this for sure. And now I have this down tree to harvest hand drill circuits from. That's cool. So it wasn't a lie the first time I made it. I just need to have it on film. Let's blow it. I had the coal in is also the same poplar leaf, so I can just put it all in the cinder bun. This is flames, this is super cool. this was a set with the spindle. That's super nice, super cool. Thanks for watching.